What's up, guys? Welcome back to a Mass Effect episode. I've just checked the poll now, and we are doing the Shore Leave DLC. Now, I'm only going to do the main storyline for the Shore Leave. And then after that, I am going to leave it until after we got Miranda. And then I shall do the ending, you know, the whole party scene. No, I was fighting the collectors. And now they're killing civilians. Dr. Chapman said word that she'd like to speak with you down in the med bay. There better be some fuel. We need the personal apartments. And this is for you, Evie.
Very generous. It's practical. We need you
must be mentioned. Is this one?
When I came to, I saw a Salarian putting the rest of the troublemakers down. A Salarian? Who the damn can, I swear. When everybody was out cold, or running, he walked over and helped me up. And said, yes. Yes, sir, I replied. He looked over my collection of unconscious friends, nodding. Not bad, you know, he said.
Not that one. Let me just read this email, otherwise it's just going to keep dinging. Where is it? So how do you know? to this one. Ah, yes. This is an EV.
The test ends when the last person runs out of oxygen.
Sounds daunting. But what happens to the ones who run out there first?
Out of the program. The best N7s can survive alone, but work together to survive even longer.
That's very impressive, Admiral. Deep space survival training. That has to be so difficult. All of it would take such strength of character. Well, just plain strength. But then you seem like a strong person.
I'm sorry. Is there a question in there?
Well, does the program make the man? Or do you think you were born for this?
It's a bit of both, I suppose. Every soldier reaches a point of their career, sometimes more than once. When they are asked to give more than they ever thought they could, that moment is the test. I've seen men and women, all sure to fail, persevere long past the point of breaking. That experience changes them. Others, with all the gifts and abilities, fail at that moment. Sometimes they pick themselves up and carry on. Sometimes they're just done.
What about you? What was your moment?
I've had a few. None of which I'd like to share. But I think the toughest tests are still ahead of me.
What makes you say that?
Call it a hunch.
Soldier's intuition?
Something like that.
Do you trust your intuition? I mean, do you follow your heart over your mind?
Well, it depends on the day. No, I suppose if I were to be honest, I do trust my instincts. The problem is, war isn't orderly. And the enemy is never predictable. Even the most experienced veteran is going to find themselves in situations they haven't trained for. In those instances, and there's more than I'd like to admit, your instincts are the only thing keeping you alive. Fact. And the men and women you're fighting beside.
But soldiers are only as good as their leader, isn't that true?
Yeah. A good leader can make an okay squad great. A bad leader, well, war tends to make examples of them.
What makes a good leader then?
A good leader is someone who values the life of his men over the success of the mission, but understands that sometimes the cost of failing a mission is higher than the cost of losing those men.
That's a terrible line to have to walk.
Yes, it is. But war is a terrible thing.
Thank you for your time, Admiral.
Thank you.
The remainder of this interview was to take a more personal look.
But there we have it. You know, to be in the N7 program, you get dropped off on the on the remote planet with a limited supply of oxygen, and the first one that runs out of oxygen loses. Hi. Is that all you want?
Come in, don't share. You play with us, play. I knew about this place before.
Oh, shut up. No shots on the other
day. Hey, Shepard, not bad, huh? Since you play some serious, like, French guy.
Is that a real thing? If you work for NASA, let me know. Do you do space-time rotations? No, I don't know either.
I'm Staff Analyst Maya Brooks, Alliance Intelligence. There were people trying to kill you.
Yeah, I think he's aware of that.
No, I don't mean servers and the Reapers. I mean other people, new people. Someone is hacking your account. Comm channels, personal records.
They're targeting you specifically.
Big
mistake. Oh
man, there's the angry face.
From the top. What do you know?
Excuse me, you don't have a reservation.
Yeah, they've got guns.
Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, tonight's performance is brought to you by a
That looks like it hurts. Ow, 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 ow. Oh. Ow. Yeah, I think that really hurts.
Brooks, you got hit.
I know.
away. And hide from me that way. Who's licking the fruit?
Yeah.
Got a point. Get out of my way. She's not very good at this, is she? Stop flirting. Please leave.
Please leave.
But what about your sky car? Meet my Krogan friend. Bye! And this is why you don't mess with a Krogan.
Sure.
I heard. Thank you, Joker. Yeah, I won't know.
Who were those mercenaries? They were heavily armed and using C-Sec shuttles.
I don't know. I've never seen them before.
I can't believe you survived all that. They had guns and grenades. And there's drone things.
Brooks, gunfire means something serious is going on. Can you keep it together long enough for us to figure this out?
They said the Medigel might make me jump. Also, the fact that I work a desk job and have never been shot before.
How did you get mixed up in this?
I monitor data for Live Intel to prevent fraud and hacking of officer IDs. Like, someone using an Admiral's pass to get into the nightclub on the Citadel when that Admiral is fighting on T'Chanka. I wrote a tracking program. It's really neat. I named it a Super Skits, after my cat.
Brooks.
Right, sorry. Anyway, Mr. Bis, my program detected a breach in your classified files. Soon, everything we had on you was compromised. Personnel files, mission reports, everything.
Since when does hacking personnel records involve heavy weapon fire?
When the Krogan does it. Right, guys, I am going to wrap this up here, and then the next episode will be the continuation. I know, I like it.
Permission to come aboard, Shepard.
Permission denied. Anyway, guys, thank you for watching. You come back tomorrow for part two of this, and I shall see you then. I am Commander Cessus, and I shall go.